Hi, my name is Jenny Bolt. I'm with the Drinking Water and Environmental Health Division of the Michigan Department of Environment, Great Lakes and Energy. We're going to be going over the Preliminary Distribution System Materials Inventory, commonly known as DSMI. It's an upcoming requirement due January 1st, 2020. So we're just going to be going through a general overview of the purpose, and then we're going to be doing a separate little section on going through the form specifically. So this video will be good for anyone who possibly missed any training or upcoming or information about this and needs a general overview. So like I said, the DSMI, it's a new requirement put in by the June 2018 rule revisions to the lead and copper provisions of the Michigan Safe Drinking Water Act. It's required of every community and non-transient, non-community water supply. Like I said, it's due on January 1st, 2020, and we're doing a preliminary DSMI initially and then a more complete verified inventory due January 1st, 2025, with the expectation that these inventories will be updated every 5 years. We know that supplies have very different starting points as far as what information they have already on hand as far as what's in the ground for their distribution system. But the goal of this is to get every system statewide on the same page, to be able to compile and review all of their available records, to summarize that information by the material of the service line, to then characterize if they have any gaps in data or if they have any issues with accuracy or completeness, and then to be able to use this for any future planning, especially as far as other upcoming requirements for inventories and service line removal requirements. Where you're going to be looking for the sources of information can be varied depending on your system, but you should generally look at any of the existing ordinances that you have, permits that you have, billing records, any existing information that you already have on hand. The purpose of this preliminary, like I said, is to compile this information to be able to put together something comprehensive of what you know right now. The form that we have available for submitting your preliminary DSMI is available online at michigan.gov/LCR for lead and copper rule. You may have seen a memo sent to all community water supplies in April of 2019. For your convenience, the form is available in Word or PDF, depending on if you'd like to fill it out online or not. And it does include instructions in the back of the form. Like all other submissions, these should be sent to your local district email box, and they need to be submitted by January 1st, 2020 to meet this deadline. So going through some things in the form, the first question that you need to read completely and understand is that there's been a redefinition of what a service line is, and then also whether or not all of this form will be applicable to your system or only portions of it. Whether your system has service lines and needs to fill out the form in its entirety, or if your system does not have any service lines and needs to skip to just a smaller subset of questions, questions in 7-8, and then still turn in the form. When you should be checking no is if you do not have service lines and your water supply is solely comprised of premise plumbing. We're going to go through those two concepts as far as premise plumbing and lead service lines if you're just not sure. So premise plumbing is the portion of a drinking water system that is associated kind of with the internal portion of a building. So a school, a hospital, this even extends to the internal plumbing of a private home. A service line is from the discharge of the water main at the corporation stop through the pipe that connects the water main to the home, and then into the home to the first shutoff valve or 18 inches within the home, whichever is shorter. And then if any portion of this contains lead, it could be all lead, it could just be a small portion of lead just at the gooseneck. If any portion between the discharge of the corp and 18 inches within the home or the first shutoff valve is lead, then this is determined to be a lead service line. So we're going to quickly go through the form. I think we're going to do the form in a different section, and we're just going to kind of go through, like I said, the overview right now. So we've gone through the preliminary DSMI, and we want you to keep this in the back of your mind. Eagle is still currently working on the guidance and the document for the complete DSMI, but we want you to be aware of that this is also a deadline that's coming up in 5 years, and kind of what the overall plan is and progression is for these inventories, that we're looking at what we need right now, or what you have right now, to have this preliminary, and then between now and 2025, we'll be coming up with some way to be able to verify and put together a complete DSMI with information on each service line within a distribution system. Some of the big questions that we have with this is what statistically valid strategy we're going to have for verifying these service line materials without going to a need to dig up every single service line to verify the materials. And then also what existing records are going to be acceptable and which ones need verification. So this is just a potential kind of idea of the information that we may be looking for a complete inventory. But like I said, the state is still working on the document for the complete DSMI and any guidance documents to go along with that form. And we'll have those out to you as soon as practically possible. If you have any questions regarding the DSMI, please contact Brandon Onan, or as a secondary contact, you can always feel free to contact me with any questions. Thank you very much.